Hi everyone, I'm Rick Beato on today's Everything Music. It's What Makes This Song Great, Episode 19. The band is Rush, and the song is Closer to the Heart. It's coming up next. Closer to the Heart is from the Rush album, A Farewell to Kings, which came out in 1977. I remember being in ninth grade when I first heard Xanadu, one of the tracks from it, on the radio. There's actually only six tracks on the record, although Cygnus X1 has four parts, so really there's kind of 10 tracks or so. But Farewell to Kings was really a unique record, and I think a change of sound and direction for the band. And Closer to the Heart, ironically, is one of the first, or I think it was the first song that Rush actually had an outside songwriter write with them. Peter Talbot wrote the lyrics, I believe, with Neil, which was really unusual, and it happens to be one of their biggest singles that they ever had. So let's get into the beginning of the song. It begins with a really cool 12-string part that every kid in ninth grade, when I was in school, was trying to figure out. It goes like this. The song begins on an A add 9 chord, but you're only playing on the E through the D string. It goes like this. Track now. You notice in the beginning, starting on bar three, you have the synth bass and the glockenspiel that enter right here with this. So these tuned percussion parts happen in other spots in tune because there's orchestral bells that come on after the first chorus is over. And Neil uses a lot of those in Rush, which is a really cool thing. So anyways, let's talk about the verse here. I'm going to play some of the verse and I'm going to just play the instrumental. You know how the vocals go, so here we go. Now you'll notice when the verse starts, it starts on an A major chord with the open A string. Then, so the second chord is actually G major over A or A11. So it's A major. Now the verse chords, Alex goes into strumming here, and it's A, G over A. So those are the verse chords. Let's talk about the melody here. So Getty sings.
And the men who hold high places must be the ones who start.
So the melody starts on the tonic. Tonic of A. Men who hold high places. Then it goes down to the flat 7 of this A11 chord, or G major over A. Must be third of the D major, the one who starts all chord tones to mold a new reality. So on the G over A, it's going to the 13 to the 11, but it's creating this really nice sound there. To mold a new reality, then closer to the heart, all chord tones. It goes from the third of D. fifth of A to the fifth of G. So it's all chord tones in that verse melody. So the only thing that's happening in the first part of the verse is the acoustic guitar and the vocals. It's kind of like a folk tune, which is very un-Rush. And it's got a really classic hook line that's repeated, which is really kind of what was going on then in the 70s. If you think about the mid-70s and before, from the Beatles on, the just hook line repeated as a chorus, whether it's I Want to Hold Your Hand or Message in a Bottle or, you know, tunes like that, that's real classic songwriting with a repeated hook, which is probably one of the reasons that it became a really big single. So halfway through the verse, the bass and drums enter, and the bass goes like this. Okay, so what's Getty doing there? This is really great. This is one of these archetypal Rush bass lines. So he starts on the root, right? And then in the G over A chord, he goes to the G. And then he goes. He plays, starts up D major. Then he walks up to the fifth of the A chord with a little fill to the sixth. Then down to the fifth of the G chord. There's a little fill there. And then he goes D, starting on the fifth of the D. Then he hits the fifth of the A chord. And then he hits the fifth of the G chord. So he's doing a lot of inversions there. To the root, fifth root, fifth root on the D, A, G. Let me solo the bass and drums so you can hear what they sound like together. It's a very straight drum beat for Neil until you get to the first fill. Here's the bass and drums together. Check them out. So after the first chorus in the interlude, the tubular bells come in that Neil's playing. Check them out. And then we're in with the second verse, where the guitars are full on, electric guitars are in, and the bass drums are in. The guitar is simply playing diamonds here in the beginning, so let's check it out. You can hear he's playing a power chord here on the A. And it repeats. Then. So the second verse is pretty much exactly the same in the bass and drums. There's a few different bass fills in it. And they have those breaks there with the bass and drums that happen with the really cool fills. Check it out right here. It's great how Neil plays across the fill here. Check it out. Let's know again in context. And then we're doing kind of a completely different feel here in the solo. And the solo is really cool. It's one of my favorite solos of Alex. It has this climbing lick that always reminded me a little bit of Brian May. I'm going to try and play along with it here. Oh, The bass is doubling the guitar riff from the intro. And then we go into the third verse, actually, which is really unusual that you have this long solo into the intro riff again, where the bass is doubling the melody of the original guitar picking thing with the 12 string. And then we go into the third verse. About the guitar solo, there's a few dual lead notes. Like the first thing starts, the first bend is really the two guitars. And then the climbing lick starts. So there's a couple other spots where it goes right here. One of the guitars is bending and one is not. Then, so it's a really cool solo. The climbing lick to me really makes it, because all the bass, the whole band plays together in unison on that, and it sounds amazing. Now, after the guitar solo, it goes back to this build-up and then into the intro again. And it has one of my favorite bass parts here. Check it out. And then into the verse, into the third verse. Let me play along with that. Killer licks there, where he's playing along with the intro guitar part. And then we go into the third verse here. And right there, it goes in just the out chorus, closer to the heart repeat of the chorus. A lot of great fills. Love that triple fill there. And then the guitar lead comes back in. And then we have the classic Neil Rototom fill. Check it out right here. Ear in context, check it out. There's a great bass lick right there that happens. It's really on almost the bottom of the bass. I'll play along with it. Then you have that high bend. And that's really right at the end of the fade. That you don't even hear those last three hits, but they do have a hard stop on the tune. And that was Closer to the Heart. That's all for now. Please subscribe here to my Everything Music YouTube channel. If you're interested in the Beato book, go to my website at www.rickbeato.com. Thanks for watching.